What's going on? My name is Mike Ciprari. I'm from SJC Custom Drums over in Boston, Massachusetts. We're here at Gear for Music in England with Jay Weinberg. Really excited to be here at this awesome studio, having Jay play on our drums, showing off the new SJC Tour Series kit and Evan's drum heads. He's straight off tour. So here to talk about what Jay's up to and just kind of how he started playing drums and everything. So
yeah. So I started playing drums in 2004-ish. I was about like 14 years old. Truthfully, it's really funny. I don't know if I've ever even talked to you about like why I started playing drums, but when I was a kid, my dad's a drummer and we'd be at the dinner table and he'd be like tapping on the dinner table, like a drummer, just like drumming on stuff. And so I picked up doing that from him at the dinner table, and my mom would yell at me for doing that and just like tapping on whatever. She's like, stop that. You can't do that. I'm like, well, he does it. Why does he do it? And I can't do it. And she's like, well, he's a drummer. If you were a drummer, you could do it and I wouldn't yell at you. So in a way, that's kind of like what started me playing drums, was because I wanted to tap at the dinner table and not get yelled at.
That's awesome.
Yeah. But you know, I had a passion for music and for heavy metal and punk rock, and I really wanted to have a little bit of that for myself. So I started out on guitar, took it a little bit seriously, but fell out of it. Started playing bass, took it seriously, but kind of fell out of it. And then when it came to drums, I just really wanted to do it for myself. I never took lessons. I didn't want to make it like school because I wanted to get like away from school. So when I was about like 14 in high school, falling out of love with hockey, which was my main passion at the time. And I was starting to find out bands and what I really liked in bands, and going to local shows and really wanted to have a piece of that for myself and, you know, start a band and all that. So I started playing drums and really, you know, didn't show anybody it. Just kind of tried to play along to Ramones records and Metallica records and stuff like that. It just gave me a sense of satisfaction to be able to do that. And it was a lot of fun just kind of being in a shed, you know, in the dead of winter in New Jersey, just like, you know, hashing out, playing along to records that I liked. After a while of doing that, I, you know, found some like-minded people and started bands and we, you know, we'd enjoy practicing all the time and we'd play a couple times locally, but, you know, we'd really just kind of like sit around, play some metal music and listen to metal bands, go to shows. Started another band in high school that was a little bit more serious. And we'd play like every week, or we'd play a show like every 2 weeks or something like that. And that was my first experience like touring, you know, where we'd get like a rental van because our guitar player's dad ran like a Dodge dealership. So we would like get a van off the lot that he would just let us take. And you know, we're 16, 17 years old. So like the guy in the band that was 17 that could drive us, like we would, you know, we'd tour out of state. And so when I was 17, we did our first like New Jersey to Florida and back kind of run, you know, just the three of us. And that was exciting. And then after that, you know, I started college and played, you know, played with some people in New York, because I was close to New York then. And then got the opportunity to play with Bruce in the E Street Band, because of the scheduling conflict that my dad had with Bruce and with the Tonight Show at the time that he was on. So that was in the winter of 2009, and that just kind of, you know, I was 18 at the time, and that just kind of kicked me off the cliff into the world of touring nonstop and kind of like high stakes.
Right. Playing, big time, kicking off the cliff.
Yeah. Playing for people that really, you know, that have enjoyed this music for a long time. And you know, you got to respect the music, respect the players and the band and take it really seriously. You know, this isn't a garage band that I started in high school. This is completely something else entirely. So kind of starting out my touring, you know, my time touring, with that, I think it made me take it really seriously. It made me really respect the process of learning, you know, who my bandmates are, who I'm collaborating with, and their musical history, that I'm coming into something that's existed for a long time. And that's really what I, that's really the attitude that I've taken through every project that I've been involved with over the last, you know, almost 7 or 8 years now. So my drumming really kicked into high gear with playing with Bruce. I've been playing for about 4 years at the time. So I had rudimentary knowledge about playing drums, and I could play with passion, and I could play what was inside me. And I think that is what got me, that's what got me through that challenge of you know, taking on a catalog of 40 years of music, you know. And it was the most intense learning curve, but it really, you know, it was fight or flight, and I really enjoyed that experience, and that kind of set the stage for, you know, all the stuff that I've been up to since.
Similar to Jay, you know, joining a band like that and kind of having that learning curve and the fight or flight kind of thing, you know, with SJC, we were very passionate about building drums and wanting to start this company from nothing and learning how to do it on, you know, in front of the world almost, you know, with social media and everything. When we started to get popular, I guess you can say, we were kind of in the light with all these people, and we were very transparent about that, like showing our shop on video and stuff like that. And my biggest thing was being passionate and being real and networking and meeting people. And so when SJC started, I wanted to go out there and make drums for my favorite bands. And, you know, I love Green Day and I love Rancid, and those are the first records I bought, and Strike Anywhere. And like, I want to make drums for those dudes, you know, because they're why I play the drums, and it would just be so cool to know that they had a drum from us. And so that's how Jay, you know, you and I met through Brandon.
Yeah.
I had networked my way to work with Rancid, and I had drum tech for Brandon. And one day he called me and he's like, yo, I'll never forget, I was on a plane and he called me and he's like, yo, I have Jay Weinberg on the phone. And I'm like, holy shit, all right, cool, let's talk. Yeah, fuck yeah. And like, we started talking. And so that's kind of how we met and got together years ago.
Yeah, and that was back in 2010.
Yep.
Like late 2010. It was before I was going to go on tour with Madball, and I needed a kit, and but Brandon, shout out Brandon Steinickert. I had known Brandon for a long time, going back to when the Used were first, you know, putting out records and touring and stuff. And I was a big fan of his and big fan of the Used. And that was a big part of like me trying to learn how to play drums. It was like, after I figured out how to play along to Ramones records and whatnot, I'd like try to play along to like the Used records. And seeing Brandon play was one, even though I grew up in a musical household with a dad that's a drummer and stuff, going to see a band that I really liked and that I was just getting into, like the Used, and watching Brandon play, that at a young age, like 12 years old or something, I saw him and I was like, that looks like so much fun. I want to do that. And because he just looked like he was having the time of his life, and he was expressing himself, and I didn't know how I would end up there, but I wanted to do that so bad. So Brandon and I become friends, and then over the years, as he started playing with Rancid, you know, and he, and I was always a fan of, like, he's always had an art brain, that I think he and I kind of share, and that, he's always had interesting kits. So when he started, playing SJC drums, and he had you guys build this, kit based on the TV show Dexter, that like blew my mind, and he posted pictures about it online, and I just texted him. I was like, what is that? Because it was like, I'm a fan of acrylic shells, but it was a totally different take on it, in that it, you know, it looked like saran wrap that Dexter would like wrap his like victims in, and stuff.
It had
blood splatter, and even the details of the badges,
slides,
of being the slides and everything. It was so cool, and then I'd never seen anything like that. I'd never seen a drum or drum set that was like seriously a playable piece of art. So that was really cool. And I asked him about it. I was like, what's the deal with this company? And so he was like, dude, I can get you on the phone with the owner in like 20 minutes. I was like, all right. So, so that's what he did. He just introduced us right there. And I wanted to, you know, spitball ideas of things that I've had in my head, but could never execute really. And so we got to talking. Then you guys sent out a kit for me to use on this Madball tour that I had coming up. And it was kind of right from there. We hit the ground running. We started spitballing ideas with the first kit that we made together. Was like the Frankenstein's monster on the kicks, and like all this like horror movie poster imagery and stuff. Super cool. I love that kit. And I think every time I've come up with like an idea to make it even crazier and stuff, you guys have always delivered and always made it that, you know, music meets art, and together it's something that's like, that's bigger than the two, and you can really make like a, just an expressive piece that's like, it's everything. And, you know, it looks just as great as it sounds, and it's just like inspiring to play. So I knew that from the moment we were introduced by Brandon, that we shared like this commonality, this common like vision for how we wanted drums to be, and how we wanted the culture to be. And so it was kind of like, it was an honor for me to be a part of the SJC roster with all these drummers that I like and that I consider peers. And then we can all grow together, because we all come from like punk rock ways of doing things. So that's how we met, and we've only continued to, I think, push the envelope. Like every time we have a new idea, we just, you know, just do it.
It's awesome, man. It's like a dream team with working with you and Brandon and everybody on our roster. It's great. We all share that culture, and the art meets music, and marrying the two together. And that's kind of what we wanted to be as a company from the get-go. You know, we never wanted to be a business and a corporate thing where we cared about our bottom line, although we probably should have a few years ago. But I didn't give a crap about that stuff. You know, I really wanted to just make dudes happy and build awesome drums. And I think that is ingrained in the DNA of the company. And having dudes like you and Brandon and all the great guys that we have that bring on new ideas and critiques and, you know, just constructive criticisms and just ideas and art, that punk rock, I guess, ethos that we all share is the common bond. That it's like, yeah, we're a company, we pay bills, and we have, you know, things that any company has, but at the end of the day, and like really like the DNA of the company is this, like the we're both artists and we come from that punk rock DIY ethic, and that's how we can go do cool stuff like this here at Gear for Music, or and promote each other in a cool way, you know?
And I still run into drummers like all over the world that play SJC, and I feel like every time I meet another drummer that plays SJC, I have something in common with that guy.
Yeah.
And I've never met before, but I know we can have a conversation. And
right.
I've said it before, but it's just like, I really feel like there's a true family that we all have that in common. And there's some sort of, it's intangible, but I know that there's something with, like, if you play SJC, you kind of have a certain way that you approach music and approach what you do. And so I think there's a lot of passionate players out there that they choose SJC for a reason, because they see that it reflects the passion that they have for the music, and that's why it's such a good fit. So I love meeting people all over the world that play SJC, because it really is that, like, we are a huge, huge family.
Yeah, I love that. So I remember being introduced to you, I was on the plane, Brandon from Rancid, we had just started working together maybe like a year before. And Brennan calls me up, and I was about to take off on this plane. He's like, yo, I got Jay Weinberg on the other line. And I was like, oh my God. Cause I'd wanted to work with you for a while, seeing what you had been doing. And so we talked, and then kind of the rest is history from there. We've been doing great, great stuff together ever since. So over the past like 6 years, we've made you a bunch of different styles of drums, acrylic, long kick drums, shorter kick drums. And now recently with all the drums that you're playing, you know, I've done a couple of Babinga kits, and what's your favorite drums that you've gotten from SJC so far?
Mine are now the newest ones that I've been playing. And truthfully, you actually might know more about the details than I would, but I'll do my best. They're maple shells. How many plies are the kits?
They're 5-ply.
Okay. And they have rings on. They have reinforcement rings on.
So we're doing the 5-ply. This recent kit was a 5-ply maple kit, but each individual ply was much thicker than like a 6-ply shell.
Right.
And they have reinforcement rings on there.
Yeah. So we've been using those kits on the last bunch of Slipknot tours, and they are perfect. And everybody, it's funny because like just everybody in the band is like, these are the best kits that you've had this whole time. It's ironic because we just finished up touring. But these new kits that we've been toying around with, they're totally, totally rad. It's a little bit shallower of a kick drum than I usually use. I remember last summer I was using one that's a 22-inch. I always use a 22-inch head, but I think we we were 22 inches deep.
Yeah, you did a 22 and then a 20, and now we're at 18.
And now we're at like 18.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I'm finding the shallower that we get them, even though like big drums, I mean, you know, they do sound great and they look cool and all that. Like, I find the shallower we've made the drums, the it's just the more appropriate sound that I like. It's quick. It has a lot of slap in your face that I really like. But it's just got a lot of body to it. And like, when you mic it properly, and we usually use like a couple different mics on our kicks. And I use two individual kick drums with two single pedals. You know, that's been the real sweet spot for me. I love those kick drums. And same with the toms. We've been going a little shallower on the toms too.
Yep.
I know we have the 10, the 12, and the 13. The 13 has been like a little more shallow, so it'll fit over the lip of my kick, because I like to have my toms like, some people have their kicks like really far out and their toms can like come further over the lip. I like mine to kind of sit like right above the lip, because I sit really forward on my kicks. So I need that little like extra shallower of a drum, so I can tilt it the way I want it to, and it's been sounding incredible. So with those kicks and those toms, it gets me all that, like, it's a super fluid sound. Everything just like sounds really nicely tone matched, and even with this kit, like, everything is really, the tones just really match each other well. And with the Evans heads that I'm using, it really, I can find my tone. And then we found last summer, when we came up with the idea, you came up with it. At the time, I was using metal snares, which I really enjoy. I like brass snares are great. I was using an acrylic snare at one point. And I just had this idea of like, God, it'd be really cool to do something that's just like all crack, all attack, you know, just offensive and loud and everything. You know, just like overdo it on every level, put vents, make it super thick ply. And so you like came up with the idea and you were like, we can have this to you ASAP. And so like, it might've been the next day or a couple days later, you had this snare for me that was 48 plies, two vents on the sides, that we mic. So we mic the bottom, we mic the side, and we mic the top. And it is so stupid loud, but it's perfect. It's exactly what I need for music like Slipknot plays, where it's super quick. You need to be in and out. You need to be you need that aggressive pop that comes from a snare like that. So I've found that that's really, after testing all these great snares that sound awesome, metal and acrylic and different wood and all that, even trying different wood with the kicks and the toms, like different Babinga kits, now with like these maple shells, the maple snare with the really thick ply, the vents and everything, that is my sound. Like that's totally it. For that project, especially like other projects that have maybe a little bit more experimental qualities, I'll try different stuff, like a lesser ply of a snare drum. But for that, that's been like, it's just exactly what I need. It's consistent every night. And yeah, I don't know. It feels it just feels appropriate for what I'm doing at the moment with my playing. And yeah, I mean, like you guys just hit it right out of the park with the awesome ideas that I had. So it was perfect.
Cool. So I remember probably like 4 years ago now, maybe, you called me and you said you started painting, you know, doing different canvas and stuff, and you wanted to come up to our shop and paint a drum set. So I was way down with it because I thought that was super cool. We love thinking outside the box and doing different kind of art forms on drums. And plus, having you up at our shop to paint would be really sick. And it eventually, you know, I'd like for you to talk about that kit, but it eventually turned into these events that we're doing now, which is another reason why we're out here in England. We're going to do an event at the Wardrobe in Leeds this weekend, and having kids come out, you're painting your own 48 ply snares, which was so cool that you're playing those snare drums. you're painting them personally, and then we're putting them on our website, and kids have the chance to actually buy them. Yeah. So really, really cool thinking outside the box, back to that like punk rock ethic and culture that we have. So really awesome to be doing that with you. So if you want to talk about that kit and how it evolved.
Yeah. So I think in the spring of 2012, when I had I'd been doing, paint like off tour, I want to channel creativity in different ways. And so I was just I was painting a lot. And so I had the idea, I was like, man, I'd love to do something on a canvas, like a drum set. I want to paint my own drum set and play it. And, we'll assemble all the hardware and I'll use this on tour. So, against me, we were figuring out our gear situation for a bunch of European tours. And I was like, okay, I can make this kit. We'll send it over to Europe and I'll use it as my European kit. We'll store it over here. And, so I made this kit. I came up to the warehouse and painted it in a day or maybe a day and a half. And it was rad. It was just a really fun experiment that I've never painted, a canvas like that before. And it came together awesome. And that just kind of put the seed in my mind of God, I'd love to keep doing this and see where I could go with painting drums and how far I can take it. And with you guys being, custom is in the name. It's everything is straight up custom. So you can't get more custom than a guy hand painting things on a drum. It's a playable piece of art, and that's how I've always considered SJC drums to be. So having my own kind of artistic expression and interpretation or whatever, just doing that is a really fun thing for me to do. And so now that we've found this drum, this snare drum that I really like playing, that I feel kind of embodies my playing and stuff, why not take it that much further and design it myself and design one of one original pieces, playable pieces of art that is, me painting a canvas, we slap hardware on it and it's there. And, it doesn't exist anywhere else in the world. That's it. So that's been a really exciting thing. And it's not to talk ill of any other company, but I really can't imagine any other, anybody else taking on this kind of project. It has to start with that kind of punk rock ethos of I came up with this idea and called you and was like, yeah, can you send me a snare and I'm going to paint it. And let's just see where it goes. And you were down to do it. And so that was really exciting for me because it is that easy. It's that easy to just kind of have an idea and execute it. Yeah. And so now that we did it and play it on tour and get it out there, someone else will have the opportunity to own it and play it. So that's been that's been super cool. So it's kind of why not? Let's just do more of this. This will be awesome. And we get to create, we get to come to places like this. Come to Leeds and do an event based on this. We already did one in Nashville where I live and, have people, anybody who's interested come and check out the creation of this thing. And then I don't know, just create, it just furthers the cause of SJC and creative pursuits and whatever. It's just really fun to do. So I'm glad that we kind of have the mindset of just taking an interesting idea and following it to the to the furthest extent. And there's a great testament to that being in the UK, doing a painting event where I'll paint these drums, we'll assemble them, play on them possibly later in the day, and that's just that's fun. It creates a really cool culture and atmosphere, and it's just really exciting to be a part of that.
Awesome. So if you want to check out more about SJC, Evans, Jay Weinberg, or Gear for Music, head over to Gear for Music's website and speak to the friendly people over there. And all of us are happy to work with you.